Ceasefire has been reached. This just in, between Israel and Gaza militants after one of the bloodiest weekends since the start of the 2014 conflict there. Nearly 700 rockets fired into Israel. Jeff Paul is live on the ground along the Israel-Gaza border. He joins us now with these very latest developments. Hey, Jeff.
Yeah, Julie, we're here in southern Israel, not too far away from the Gaza-Israel border, and we were in the same area just yesterday, and this field behind me was empty. But as you take a look off to the side of me, you can see it's a much different story. It is now full with a brigade of tanks and other armored vehicles as Israel prepares itself for any further escalation of violence, despite a ceasefire being reached earlier this morning. Over a two-day span this past weekend, Israel says nearly 700 rockets were fired from Gaza. Four people were killed in Israel, with rockets hitting several neighborhoods. Israel responded to the rocket fire with airstrikes that leveled several buildings in Gaza. At least 27 Palestinians were killed, including two infants and two pregnant women. Following the ceasefire today, Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu released a statement that reads in part, "The campaign is not over and it demands patience and sagacity." Hamas then responded, saying in part, "Our message was delivered in this round and we are ready for the next confrontation." Now, a senior Hamas official in Gaza told us that the ceasefire was reached in conjunction with the help of Egyptian officials as well as UN mediators. He says if they want this latest ceasefire to be successful, that both sides, including Israel, they're going to have to live up to their commitments of the past. Julie.
Jeff Paul, thank you.